subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. The Holy Land of India is home to a number of cultures and lifestyles that all possess their own unique set of festivities. Sita Navami is among the most significant festivals in the country, celebrated by Hindus. It is observed with great zeal and enthusiasm, especially in northern part of India. But this year, amid coronavirus outbreak, the festival was observed in a quite decent manner, adhering to the lockdown norms. Have a look.
With nationwide lockdown imposed to curb the spread of COVID-19, temples, shops and other places of worship remain closed during the erstwhile colourful festival of Sita Navami. Following the government's appeal to keep the celebrations of the festival a low-key, homely affair, the temples were silent with just the sound of bells and prayers were to be heard.
ऐसे जो सीता महारानी हैं उनके जन्मदिन पर हमने उनसे आरती करते समय यही प्रार्थना किया कि हे माँ, ये जो विश्व में ये जो आपदा आई हुई है उसको आप अपनी कृपा से इसको समाप्त करें।
Priests in Ayodhya city of Uttar Pradesh practiced social distancing as they offered prayers to mark the birth anniversary of Hindu goddess Sita. Songs were sung and aarti was performed in front of idols of Hindu god Rama, his wife Sita, as priests celebrated Janaki Navami in a temple amid coronavirus lockdown. Priest Karuna Nidhan said prayers were offered to the goddess to stop the spread of coronavirus in the country.
सांकेतिक व्यवस्थाएं होती है उसके हिसाब से हम लोग का जो नियम है जलाभिषेक करना दुधाभिषेक करना फिर बहुत प्रकार के खोरसों प्रकार से पूजन करते हुए भगवान के श्रृंगार को करते हुए बधैया बजाते हुए बधाई गान करते हुए भगवान की आरती खोरसों प्रकार से हम लोग किए आज सुबह से ही सभी श्रद्धालु भक्तजन भगवान श्री सीता जी के जन्म महोत्सव मनाने के लिए बहुत ही उत्सुकता के साथ लोग लगे हुए थे।
सीता नवमी इज सेलिब्रेटेड ऑन द 9th डे ऑफ द वैक्सिंग मून इन द मंथ ऑफ वैसाख और स्प्रिंग व्हिच कोइंसाइड्स विद द ग्रीगोरियन मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल मई। This day is believed to be the birth anniversary of holy goddess Sita, wife of Lord Vishnu's 7th avatar, Lord Ram, and the princess of Mithila, the kingdom of Raja Janak. Sita was the adopted daughter of Raja Janak as he found her while plowing the land and hence the baby got her name, Sita, from the word seep that means a plowed land in Sanskrit.
India is known for its diversity, where people of different faiths have been living together peacefully for ages. No matter how different their culture or lifestyle may be, they have always stood by each other, be it the times of joy or sorrow. At present, when the country is facing coronavirus outbreak and no vaccination has been found yet, India, like many other countries, is going ahead with plasma therapy, which involves taking blood from a person who has recovered from COVID-19. In such a scenario, people from Tablighi Jamaat who have recovered from the virus are breaking their Ramadan fast to donate plasma for COVID treatment. Have a look.
Tablighi Jamaat, which drew flak from being the super spreader of the COVID-19 until few days back, is again in news for something exactly contrarian. Its members are volunteering in large numbers for the plasma donation after recovering from the disease. Arshid Ahmed from Jhajjar in Haryana, who was discharged from a Delhi hospital few days back, has donated his plasma twice and says will do it 10 times if required.
हम ऑलरेडी दो मर्तबा दे चुके हैं, 10 मर्तबा मांगा जाएगा तो हम देने को तैयार हैं.
Plasma therapy comprises treating a patient with the plasma of a recovered patient who has developed antibody against the disease. The members of Tablighi Jamaat are donating their plasma without caring to whom it will be injected, thus serving their own bit in the fight against coronavirus.
एक फख्र महसूस हो रहा है कि अल्लाह ने एक जिंदगी दी थी, शायद इंशाल्लाह किसी के काम आएगी. ये प्लाज्मा देके वाकई में मुझको बड़ी खुशी हो रही थी. मैं नहीं जानता कि मेरा प्लाज्मा किसको जाएगा, किस धर्म वाले को जाएगा, किस जाति वाले को जाएगा, या किसको जाएगा, मुझको नहीं मालूम. लेकिन अल्लाह से दुआ कर रहा हूँ कि अल्लाह ताला जिसको भी ये जावे तो वो सेहतयाब हो जावे और उसकी ज़िंदगी वाकई में इंसानियत वाली रहे. ये मेरी दिल से दुआ है.
Although there is a little information on the efficacy of the treatment, plasma therapy is being used across the world to treat the COVID-19 patients in critical condition. Recovered patients from across the country are coming forward to donate their plasma to save the precious lives of their countrymen, irrespective of their caste and community.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
In a control room typically used for managing traffic, dozens of officials monitor a giant screen showing surveillance camera feeds from across the Agra city of Uttar Pradesh. Now dubbed the Corona Control Room, it has been used for monitoring and contact tracing of suspected and confirmed coronavirus cases across Agra for the past few months. Authorities have turned the city of nearly 1.6 million people, best known for its white marble Taj Mahal, into a virtual fortress, sealing off almost all coronavirus hotspots and coming down hard on lockdown offenders to contain the spread. Nearly 90 hotspots have been cordoned off, surveyed and effectively sealed in Agra, using a strategy that has won praise as a potential playbook for India to control the outbreak.
We are using the interrogation that we use in the criminal activities, because sometimes people don't tell the truth where they went, how they got these viruses. So based on their technical data, based on their feedbacks, based on their family members' interrogation, we are trying to compile from where he might have got the virus and wherever he might have left the viruses. So their background also and their primary, secondary and tertiary contacts we are trying to finalize. Based on that, we pick the people and then quarantine them so that the spread in the society will get contained.
Outside, on Agra's deserted roads, hundreds of policemen have been deployed at hotspots and checkpoints. At major intersections, loudspeakers blare messages asking residents to stay indoors. In early March, India's first cluster of infections was traced back to a businessman who had recently returned to Agra from Italy. Indian Navy and Coast Guard illuminated their ships off the coast of Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal at the dusk to honor the health workers and police who are working on the front line to battle COVID-19. The outlines of ships illuminated as soon as the sun set, playing music and shooting flares in the sky.
In the Navy, the ships are the best way of expressing the Navy. So at the moment, you can see five ships which are illuminated at anchorage here in Mumbai Harbour. We have just seen the flares also being fired, and this is our way of expressing gratitude.
Earlier in the day, India's armed forces took to the skies to thank the country's healthcare workers and emergency services battling the coronavirus pandemic. Air Force planes staged flypast over many major cities, and flower petals were showered from helicopters onto applauding healthcare workers outside hospitals. Some military bands were also played in their honor. Over 2,000 passengers, including migrant workers from Uttar Pradesh, who were stranded in Gujarat and Maharashtra states, were brought back home through special trains. India announced special trains for stranded migrant workers, pilgrims, tourists and students to return home during the ongoing 40-day lockdown imposed to curb the spread of coronavirus.
कोई दिक्कत नहीं हुई, सब
कैसा लग रहा है आपको?
हमें सही लग रहा है, रास्ते में हर सुविधा ही थी, खाने पीने की सब.
With the deployment of the special trains, hundreds were seen queuing up at the railway stations, some with small children, in hope of returning home. Authorities were seen sanitizing the train coaches, screening the passengers, and ensured they practiced social distancing at the railway stations.
Next, we move on to our section of Asia Buzz, where we will see how Japan is gearing up to deal with coronavirus outbreak, along with exploring its famous city of glasses, Sabe. The Nippon Foundation of Japan is all set to prepare huge temporary medical treatment facility across the country and is therefore encouraging social contribution. Have a look.
Amidst coronavirus crisis, the collapse of medical system is a big problem. In such a scenario, Japan's the Nippon Foundation has declared to prepare huge temporary medical treatment facility which will be built in Museum of Maritime and Science, Para Arena in Tokyo, and on the private land in Tsukuba City. The Nippon Foundation is encouraging social contribution worldwide, and a bold and quick decision has triggered anti-corona contribution across Japan.
Nippon 財団はね、ワンワールドと、一つの世界ということを標榜して人道的な活動を世界的にやっております。特に災害対策ではもう命一番に日本財団は現地に駆けつけて救援活動をするということにしております。今回のコロナの騒動を私は見たときに、これも災害だということで、日本の言葉に備えあれば憂いなしということがございまして、医療崩壊の危機というテレビニュースを見まして、日本ももしそうなった時どうするかということを考えました時に、 これはやっぱり備えあれば憂いなしで私たちは私たちなりにそういう収容所の施設を作っておこうともう本当の病院と同じようなレベルでやらなきゃいけないというところまで、来たのが現実でございますが常に災害にはスピードが必要でございますそして決断を持ってスピードを持ってやるということが大事なのでこれは私たちだけではなくてこれを申し上げた結果いろいろなところで公的なところも民間のところも施設の提供ということが始まりつつあるきっかけができたということは大変素晴らしいことだというふうに思っております。パラリンピックの選手たちの体育館がないということで我々急遽作ったところがありますがこれも病床にするとアリーナですから一見してさっと見えますから看護婦さん一人当たりで患者さんの数を余分に見られると広々とした隣は緑の公園でございますから空気はよろしいですし表にも出られますんでね海も眺められますしそういう点では精神的には相当余裕の持てるいい場所でございます。
The Nippon Foundation defines its mission, special innovation. To increase its prominence, the Nippon Foundation promotes it among the citizens, corporations, non-profit organizations, governments, and international bodies all over the world. Next, we take you to Sabe City in Fukui Prefecture, which is known as the City of Glasses around the world. Just carrying the label Made in Sabe means great quality.The city over 100 years has continued to develop, pioneering the technology of glass making.
Sabai にメガネを引っ張ってこられた増永さんという方が大阪からメガネを引っ張ってきてそのメガネを始めました。で、増永さんにいらっしゃったいろんなお弟子さんがサバイに独立してそれぞれ会社を作ってどんどんどんどん大きくなってきたっていうことですね。
Glass manufactured in Sabe are not just acknowledged for the innovation, but for the high quality. These manufacturers account for around 90% of all eyeglass frames made in Japan. While these big manufacturers produce in more conventional style, some craftsmen create framing using wood. These handcrafted frames allow every frame to be uniquely different from one another.
日本人ってね、こう一点物とか限定品っていうのにまあ興味があると。で、私まだ若いのにおばあちゃんが着てるの同じもん着てるって言うとね、これちょっとまずいかなって感じで。やっぱその一点物っていうのはその他にも同じものはないっていうのがやっぱそのいう魅力が、ね、惹かれるんじゃないかなと思うんですね。
Sabe City has also a museum.Where visitors can take a look at the antique glasses from around the world, along with getting to know about the rich history of the city related to eyeglass manufacturing. This museum also includes shops that exhibits and sells over 3,000 latest glasses of over 40 eyeglass companies in Fukui Prefecture. The city even hosts a special festival to celebrate glasses. It is called Megane Fest, and it's held annually.Eyeglass fans come here from all over the country, and this festival provides them with a large opportunity to connect with the creators of eyeglasses. This festival aims to highlight the uniqueness and quality of Sabe City craftsmanship, along with making it a fun experience for visitors by offering games.
サバイの中にプロフェッショナルがいてだから、最終的にいい商品ができるんですねその日本でしかできないような高品質な商品というのができるようになってるんですねすごく他の産業とは違うそういうのが違うところですね
サバイ City has pioneered in making glasses known not only for their quality but also for their culture
One can retrieve several instances of communal harmony in India when one community has come forward to help the people of other communities during the time of crisis. Setting one such similar example, a committee of Muslims in Jammu is distributing food items among the Hindu families. Have a look.
Standing in long queues, these people in the Gujjar Nagar area of Jammu are eagerly waiting for their turn to receive the food items that are being distributed by their Muslim brethren. Being a part of Mohalla Welfare Committee, Gujjar Nagar, these Muslim men have been taking care of the 150 Hindu families residing in the area amid lockdown by distributing food items to them, setting a wonderful example of communal harmony.
हम जब पैदा हुए थे तब से ये हमारे साथ यहाँ बस्ती है हिंदुओं की कम से कम कोई 150 के करीब घर है तो हमने भाईचारा वो जो बचपन से सीखा था आज तक वही भाईचारा हमने रखा है हिंदुओं की तरफ से भी मुसलमानों की तरफ से भी अगर यहाँ कोई हिंदू किसी लड़की की शादी होती है पूरे का पूरा खर्च भी मोहल्ला वेलफेयर कमेटी उठा के तो शादी करवाती है करवाई हमने हिंदुओं की यहाँ लड़कियों की शादी करवाई तो जितनी भी जरूरत पड़ती है हर एक चीज़ की हम मदद करते हैं इनके लिए
They have been distributing food items like flour, lentils, rice, sugar, vegetables and other essential items to the families. These men also go from door to door to inquire if any of the neighbors are short of any essential or food items and then make arrangements for them accordingly, thus making sure that none in the neighborhood sleeps with an empty stomach.
यहाँ हिंदू मुस्लिम का तो सवाल ही नहीं है सब भाईचारा इतने हैं कि सभी एक इकट्ठे हैं सिर्फ इंसानियत के नाते एक दूसरे की मदद करते हैं और कोई यहाँ हिंदू मुसलमान का तो सवाल ही नहीं है
मेरा बेटा ठीक नहीं था ना उसको कैंसर था तो मेरी मदद श्री हिंदू ने करी भैया ने बहुत मदद करी मेरे पहले भी दिया था अभी मदद करी मेरे घर पे आके बोल रहे थे राशन देंगे आपको
एट प्रेजेंट व्हेन द होल कंट्री इज अंडर कोरोना वायरस लॉकडाउन इन सच अ सिचुएशन अ नंबर ऑफ पीपल Cutting across the religious lines are coming forward and extending their helping hand to those in need.
The floating vegetable market on Srinagar's iconic Dal Lake, which is famous for garnering the attention of tourists for years, has today become a lifeline for the localites. Amid coronavirus lockdown, when people are asked to restrain themselves in their homes, This market is providing door-to-door service to the people residing at various corners of the lake. Have a look.
At 5 a.m. every day, the vegetable vendors in Srinagar make their way to the floating market on Dal Lake. After collecting vegetables from wholesalers and getting them loaded on their shikaras, these vendors traverse across the water body to make the vegetables accessible to the locals at their doorstep. This floating market is serving perpetually during coronavirus lockdown as the vendors have been showing up to do their business just as they do in the past despite the fear of corona spread.
इसकी खासियत है ये हर जगह जगह पहुंचता है ये फ्राइड सब्जी होती है यहाँ पे शुरू होती है सवेरे कम से कम मॉर्निंग में ये 5 बजे स्टार्टिंग होता है 5 बजे से लेके 7:30 या 7 बजे तक खत्म तो ये सब्जी हम घर घर पे पहुंचाते हैं जैसे मानो यहाँ पे कम मार्केट आज तक बंद नहीं हुआ है
This floating vegetable market on Dal Lake is one of its kind in the country and also a prime tourist attraction in the Kashmir Valley. It's running for the last several years and even during the lockdown, it has kept on providing its services to the locals adhering to lockdown norms. Moreover, as the shape and solo occupancy of a boat keeps the vendors away from each other. It also minimizes the chance of virus spread. Fearing the contraction of the virus, even the city vendors have prioritized their purchases from this market.
यहाँ तो ताज़ा मिलता है। अगर मंडी में जाएंगे वहाँ तो 2 दिन का होगा यहाँ तो ताज़ा होते हैं इसीलिए यहाँ से लेते हैं हम सब्जी बाहर बेचते हैं अगर मान लो यहाँ 10 रुपए है, हम तो 12 रुपए बेच रहे हैं।
Besides feeding locals amid lockdown, the floating vegetable market is also playing an important role in fighting the virus by preventing people from gathering, thereby stemming the spread.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.